Let's start our lives right now.
I can't do that.
What is it? You're not telling me something. I know it. What?
It's about a young man living in a town that's hidden from the world, and into this town comes this strange young girl.
So you're not immortal. What are you then?
We prefer the term caster. The casters are sort of a higher species. You know, they're a sophisticated group of witches, but you can't call them that. They don't like it.
Are you all right? They're supernaturals. They're not immortals. They're people who have powers beyond the finite abilities of most mortals.
Powers?
Yeah.
Casters are either dark or light. Some of her family is dark and some are light.
And each has their own unique and special powers.
I have power over the elements, earth, air, fire, water.
Lena is a natural. Her powers are magnified.
And yet she's a teenage girl who wants to just be a normal teenage girl.
Lena, we have a guest.
I go to school with Lena. I'm Ethan White.
You have to control your emotions. Loving this boy puts you in terrible danger.
I play a character called Makin, who is a caster.
Lena will not turn dark. She's too strong.
You see the way she looks at the boy? There's no getting in between them now.
It becomes a Romeo and Juliet story and then a race against time.
That boy is a danger to you. Don't invite him here again.
No matter what they do to me, I'm still here.
And these books hold the histories of the casters from around the world.
She's a keeper. I show her the sacred book because she is trying to fight her destiny.
When a female caster turns 16, we face what they call acclaiming. My powers will be claimed for either the light or the dark. I don't know who I really am inside.
Lena's 16th birthday falls on the most powerful solstice in 5,000 years, and more energy will be released than ever before and transferred to her. It's a big deal.
If she becomes a dark caster, she will be the most powerful dark caster in the world, and the same for the light.
She's a girl, actually, who has an increasingly strong amount of power that she doesn't know what to do with.
I play Ridley Duquesne. She is the older cousin of Lena Duquesne.
Ridley was a great girl, but she was destined to become a bad girl.
I loved how kind of deliciously evil Ridley is. She's kind of your ultimate bad girl with a teeny tiny heart of gold underneath.
You think you can keep Lena so good?
Wasn't I the same before I was claimed? Look at what I am now.
She has a different color hair every time. She's daring in her clothing. She's very out there.
I think I found something.
It's so delicious to see a fable of this kind being put together in this day and age.
I had the most amazing time making this movie.
I don't believe that we have one fate and no choice. We make our own lives.
I'm scared I'm gonna hurt you.
Go ahead.
And it has begun.